not going to really share how we did it. I'm just going to share a bunch of ideas. And I'm Tricia Fuglestad. I forgot that last time to say who I was. And I teach K-5 in Arlington Heights, which is a suburb up here. We're going to look at iPad animation ideas that teach art digitally, differently, and dynamically. So starting with this idea, where these are paintings by second graders of spiffy landscapes, and then they animated a semi-transparent ghost in the foreground. So we're able to teach transparency in a dynamic way. In this one, the ghost is going to haunt the painting, but not just that, it's also going to be in the painting because it's behind things in the foreground. In this idea, you're going to see that the photo is broken up into different layers, so animation can travel between the layers. So you can look at foreground, middle ground, background, relative size. That bat's going to change size, small in the background, big in the foreground, to show depth. Here, students can show that they understand perspective through this Godzilla animation. They can either animate Godzilla over a picture where they created a city scene with a vanishing point, or they can identify perspective in their environment and then have their animation travel through it. This is a creativity challenge where students were asked to create an alien that looks like it's running. So they had four stages of running, some sort of arms and legs that could move, and then any kind of alien they wanted. This was a challenge where students were going to try to use a variety of shots, sort of like in movie making, and composition to tell their story. Just three shots of 2 seconds each.
Could you pass the sheet?
The first day of school, we had an ice cream social, so we decided to interact with the screen by Edvard Munch, but we did it as a visual pun. They could be the scream, or they could be ice cream with the scream, or ice cream with ice cream, and all these different combinations. It looked like this. Students did a caricature, the big head, little body, self-portrait, and then we animated it into a bobblehead and created little animated GIFs that we could present on our website. This is a rotoscope animation. Students drew over video, and using the Do Ink animation app, it's super easy. I used to do it in such a difficult way before. But in combination with the green screen app, you can have a lot of different results. This is interacting, where you can see both the original video and the animation of the video. And here's how you can integrate your rotoscope animation with dance and music. Here they were trying to tell a story using animation and text. Again, only 6 seconds. I was saying 6 seconds because that's a perfect little size if you're going to share it through Instagram or Vine, even Twitter. Here we're interacting or making an animation based on a book, and so we're working off the illustration of the book cover of The Giving Tree. And so we kept the same color scheme and just interacted with the objects, but there's so many variations that you could go with this idea. Here we're illustrating idioms. Any guesses?
Cats out of the bag. When pigs fly.
Broken record. Cats out of the bag. What?
When pigs fly.
When pigs fly.
Oh, knock your socks off.
Knock your socks off. Yep. creativity challenge where you look at an illustration, these are old vintage illustrations, and you try to ask yourself what kind of movement either did they get stopped in the middle of, or came before it, or came after, and try to create an animation based on those illustrations. So this is a culminating video of those three ideas. Okay, so my fourth graders made movement paintings. This is what their physical work looked like. They took a digital picture of it. But then I thought it'd be really cool to make movement animations over their movement painting. So we used green screen setups in my classroom, and they created these little stop motion animations over green, which meant that in the green screen app, we can layer the two together and create these little movement over movement videos. My fifth graders were making light up robots, and their final images were so compelling that we decided to clean up the backgrounds, make them transparent, and do some animations with them. So this animation of their, so this is a physical piece of art turned into the object for animation. This one looks at rotation. And this one looks at overlap. So then we could also just start from scratch with drawn animation and think about the moving parts of robots. And that can get us thinking about simple machines, inventions, steam, connecting to steam, thinking about gears, cages, blinking lights. And then we could actually take those animations and move them through sort of like an obstacle course where they interact with simple machines, maybe like a Rube Goldberg. And these are artist trading cards, but I thought instead of just having a finished piece of art, it would be interesting to do a time lapse of the creativity process and then try a little animation in the middle, and it ends with the final look of the artist trading card. So that way, when we give the card away, we could share the video of what, well, you'll see. So it's more than just how it was made. It was how it was made and then how it interacted and then back to the same thing. This is the Crown Fountain in Millennium Park, and my students, because we're in a suburb of Chicago, when we come down for our field trip to the Art Institute, I like to do something with this paint, this public sculpture where we can interact with it. So students could actually be the crop video figure in the Crown Fountain sculpture. Here students are working on a figure drawing over a template. And then they can fly. Of a photo, transform the photo maybe into a fairy, or the same concept can be a superhero, and then animate themselves in the environment. Our time is up, so before you go,